All right, well, let's kick it off with segment number one, for which I have Kirsty Mcgrath. She is an MVP, founder, managing director, and employee experience consultant for On Point Solutions. She's out of New South Wales, Australia, where it's tomorrow, or is it yesterday, Kirsty? I can never remember.
For you, it's tomorrow. For you, you're living in the past. Yes, though.
Story of my life. And you've been an MVP, just got renewed for your fifth year. So congratulations.
That's correct. Thank you.
And you love adoption. And so do I. And our goal with this segment is really to talk about features that will help drive adoption. And one of my favorites is Excel Live and PowerPoint Live. And we're going to talk about both of those today, right?
Absolutely. So what I'm doing is I'm actually going to go directly from PowerPoint. I can present into Teams, which I do really love because I'm often already in there in the first place. Once I go over into Teams, I just press present. And what it's doing is it's actually loading PowerPoint directly into Teams, which means it really reduces down on bandwidth. So once I'm in there, what I see is different to what you see. And I can also do it through the share tray. So I click the kind of little rectangle up button and in there is PowerPoint Live. So I could have drawn it in through Teams as well if I wanted to.
Right. But don't do screen because that shares everything. Tons of bandwidth, not the best experience. Use the PowerPoint Live.
That's right. And not only that, but now because I've done it through PowerPoint Live, it means I've got access to my thumbnails. I've got my notes as well, which I don't do and I don't have if I share my screen, especially if I've only got one screen, because then I don't have a lot of features and functionality, which can get really tough.
Right. And you can also see all the people. You can also see all the chat and you can see the video of all your attendees, which if you do share full screen, you're not going to see any of that.
That's correct. So what I've got here as well is that ability to be able to, you know, see all my features, whereas you only get to see, you know, and from your point, just literally the PowerPoint presentation. Is that correct, Stephen?
Correct. Absolutely. That's all I can see. And what do you do if you want to remove, not allow everybody to see all your slides or jump forward or those things? So kind of walk through some things that you can do to control the presentation and the timing of things.
So the great thing is at the moment it's got private view turned on. So that's the little eye up the very top. And if you look at the task sort of bar running across the top, that little eye means that you can move forward and I can move forward and they're not at the same. But at any point you could go back to where I am at a point with the presenter view. Now I can turn that on or off. So you can't move as well. So it kind of gives control back. Sometimes people have turned up late, for example, and they want to go back a bit. I have other actions of being able to move around and work with it too, which is what I also love because I do have my thumbnail so I can even jump around to the very end of the presentation. I can go in and move back and forward. I have annotation tools so I can bring up my pen highlighters, for example. I also have in there the ability to be able to turn on things like translate and work my way through it. So with translate, I can put up a language, but at any point, you'll have it as on your side. So what do you see, Stephen, on your side?
Yeah, if I click on the three little dots at the bottom and I hit the drop down, I get a choice of a variety of languages that I can take the transcription translation that you're doing and put it into the language of my choice, which is great. And the same would translate the slide.
Too. Oh, yeah.
I can also translate the slide language too. Yeah.
So we've also got some different layouts as well. So those layouts allow us to be able to have me overlay on the screen. I don't really see much change. However, you might when it's been turned on. So what do you see?
Yeah, I see the slide in the background and I see you in the foreground. You look like a professional newscaster. It's pretty cool.
Putting it over the top. I can actually hide that presenter view, you know, completely as well. I can turn my slides into a higher contrast so I can adjust things around as I need to.
Awesome. This is great stuff. So let's talk about Excel Live for a minute and how that's different than this. So it's the same concept. You're in an Excel spreadsheet and you choose, you know, the whole thing present in Teams. But what's different with Excel Live over PowerPoint Live?
I think what I love about Excel Live is the fact that we can actually like co-collaborate directly inside Teams. So it's not, I have to go share my screen, a bit like we're doing kind of with PowerPoint Live. I don't have to go share the screen, share the whole desktop. I could have previously sent out permissions and we could have collaborated in the document, but I would have had to have shared my screen on top of that. But instead, if I do Excel Live, it kind of loads it in, then it reduces down the bandwidth, just like PowerPoint Live. So it will load it physically in, and when it loads it in, we can collaborate on the screen inside Teams, which is what I particularly love. So we've got all those Excel features in there because it's effectively, it becomes the app as well. So we can all work, which is fabulous. I love it.
Yeah, we're not just typing. We can sum, we can do pivot tables, we can do all this stuff together and make the data look the way we want. This is awesome. I'm super excited. Thanks for sharing.
And it's shared automatically. Yeah. I mean, the fact that it's shared automatically with my team members right then and there without me having to go do separate share links and dropping it into chat. And so it just kicks straight in. Love it.
Awesome stuff, Kirsty. Thank you so much. I love the fact that PowerPoint Live is available now. Excel Live is coming soon to folks on Insider and other things. Where should folks go to learn more about you and all the cool stuff that you do?
You can actually go to the Microsoft 365 Adoption YouTube. I've actually got a channel. It's aka.ms/M365Adoption. So you can see plenty there.
Awesome. Cool. Well, we will send folks there to check it out. And hey, you're on Instagram as MVP_decorating because you like to do cakes and you're a baker. So if you want to do something different that has nothing to do with adoption, except adopting cake, which I like to adopt, go check that out too.
Shutting the head down from all of the tech occasionally. Be the creative side.
Love it. Thanks for joining us today, Kirsty. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Stephen.
I have one of our old friends, Ragnar. MVP, 5 years out of Germany. How are you, Ragnar?
Hey, Stephen, I'm awesome. I'm excellent. Thanks for having me here.
Perfect. No, we love having you here. Take a minute, because you're an ex-Microsoftie and you work with SharePoint and a whole ton of stuff. And I love the Work Out Loud community that you did. So take a minute, tell folks who you are and spend a moment chatting about that, because I love the initiative that that you're a part of.
Yeah, so we founded this community around 2017. And the idea was that we usually do small talk about the weather, but we never talk about our goals. And here the idea was, let's use enterprise social networks like Yammer, or now called Viva Engage, to talk about our goals and help each other to grow. That was the idea. And we founded the community, built up website, Twitter, and so on and so on. And now it's a global community which transforms the way people are working. So the largest German companies are now using Working Out Loud as a cultural engine for digital transformation.
That's awesome. It just becomes a big mentorship with just great folks who you can connect with who are in the same place and doing the same thing as you. I love that. So today we're going to talk about Teams, and there's a new feature that's come out in the admin center. Take a moment and kind of tell me your thoughts on this, and then we're going to jump into a demo and show folks how to manage this.
Personally, I use chats a lot in Microsoft Teams. It delivers me a lot of value, especially when working from home, hybrid work scenarios. It brings me closer to my customers, partners, and colleagues. But it can happen that a meeting invitation is forwarded to an external person who is not invited by the meeting organizer. That's a security issue and also can create data exfiltration. The good news is that IT admins can now, in the new Microsoft Teams policies, disable the right access to this chat, the meeting policy. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can enable it using the Teams Admin Center policy and also PowerShell. Let's get started. Step number one, we are creating a Microsoft Teams meeting. We are inviting internals like Adele and Alex and also externals from a marketing agency. Adele has currently written a chat post and we can see that the colleague from the external marketing agency is waiting in the lobby. I'm going to admit it. External marketing agency is also chatting in the active meeting, but it's non-federated user, so I just created it. In a Microsoft Teams admin center, you will find here on the left-hand side under meetings, meeting policies, you're using the global policy and a section called participants and guests, and there you will find chats in meetings. You can turn it on for everyone. You can turn chats in meetings off for everyone and also turn it on for everyone but anonymous users. And that's what I'm going to test right now. In PowerShell, you connect to the Microsoft Teams module. You run a get CS Teams meeting policy My policy is currently calling global, and you see immediately the results. Important value for us just at the top called meeting chat enable type. And here, as you can see, I've already changed it to enable accept anonymous. Values which are possible, disabled, enabled, or as mentioned, enabled accept anonymous. Now she's waiting in the lobby. We can clearly see that she's waiting in the lobby, and I, as the meeting organizer, I'm going to admit her. I'm going to write, who is this anonymous user? What you can see here is that the anonymous user has no access to the chat. There is no chat window available existing on this mobile device. But she's still part of the meeting. Here you can see the most important message. The anonymous user was invited to the meeting, and there was a chat message, and then policy kicked in, and the anonymous user, who is non-federated, the anonymous user, has no longer access to the chat.
Awesome, Ragnar. So in short, what is the takeaway for IT pros here?
The takeaway is that it's very easy to implement. So you just go through Teams Admin Center, there's a toggle. It takes you just a few seconds to toggle it on. If you don't want to use Teams Admin Center and you are more a PowerShell guy, then there's also a commandlet for you. The value for the end user is less noisy chats and less distraction, and Microsoft Teams chatting is more secure and less data exfiltration.
Right. And yeah, and the big reason for this is what you don't want is, let's say you do a webinar and you have a bunch of external folks that are there. That's great. But you don't want them coming back and continuing to ask questions and digging in. That session is sort of encapsulated when you're done. That should be the end of the connection with those external folks. And this is where that's really going to help when you have one-offs with external folks that are not part of a project, not part of a team, where Teams, private chats, private channels doesn't make sense. And you're going to do a blog that will dig in deeper on this. So we'll see that on Tech Community shortly. But if folks have questions or want to reach out to you on other topics, what's the best way for them to get a hold of you?
Well, I've got a bunch of social media channels, but everything is capsuled under linktree.com/RagnarH.
Awesome. And then, of course, people can reach out to you on Twitter, and you're great. You reach back out to them. You have a really thriving community, and we appreciate that. So awesome. Thanks for joining us, Ragnar. We look forward to your blog, and this was awesome.